Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 So as we know that we are chosen by God and sent into the world with a mission. So you and I are not created for a joke. You are here. If you are amidst your family, people don't understand you, people don't love you or don't care for you, or the things are beyond your control, don't get upset. The one who is within you, the Holy Spirit, is stronger than any forces in the world. This is the basic truth, basic knowledge which you should carry. If you are allowed to go through certain problems, it is not for your destruction, but to be aware of the light and to dispel the darkness. That's what we read in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 onwards. You are the chosen generation. Amen. You are the hope I have to dispel the darkness and to establish my kingdom on this earth. So do not forget your call. Do not forget your call. God is sending with his light, with his spirit, with his presence to this dark, sinful world. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Having said this, I like to share with you the book of Job, chapter 15, verse 15 to 24. We read what the enemy does to the world. If God puts no trust in his saints and the heaven are not pure in his sight, how much less man who is abomination and filthy, who drinks iniquity like water. Look, the word of God says, if man who is created by God, if he doesn't understand his call, if he doesn't move with his creator, he will make his life a miserable one. So the goal of your life is, the call of your life is, keep alive the presence of God. Let any situation come.
Amen.
Let any atmosphere you live in, you have to, in the moment, only when you put on the switch, the light comes. Don't forget. You are not called to live and die in darkness. Put on the switch. Put on the presence of God. Wherever you are, whatever may be, the moment you kneel down, lift up your hands and call upon him, Daddy, I come into your presence. You are with me, Daddy. Thank you. Praise you. That there is, go on. Three things you do, which is number one, tell God who he is. Tell him who he is. What a mighty God you are. The stars, don't allow any other thought to come overcome you. As soon as you come, what you put is very important. Without inviting and filling yourself with his presence, the enemy will fill you with his tricks and with his evil, with his sadness, with his sin. Today the humanity church is dying. Why? People think that they are helpless. They have to run here. They have to run there. They have to hold on to some things. Please bless me and give. Please this. Sprinkle water. As though you are in a danger. Something has to help you. Somebody has to help you. No. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. God lives in you. Open your heart. And to see the Lord in you. This is the secret. So as soon as you get up, or whenever you get time, number one, train your mind to get in connect with God, who God is. That is called praising God. When I see the stars, let problem come, let people make tricks, let even evil spirit come. Why are you worried? If you are not aware of who are you, what you have inside, only then you need to be afraid. Once a great servant of God, he was sleeping. His name is Wicklesworth. He was sleeping and his cot was being shaken. He got up from his tired, he slept, he opened and saw the evil spirit with a dark face. You are the one who came. He again slept.
Praise God.
Go! Because if you are aware of who are you, the Lord in you. I thought some breeze has come, some wind has come, some storm has come. You came, get out. Again he slept peacefully. You have the power within you. You have the presence of God in you. So you have to be, you have to lit the candle. Nobody will lit the candle. You only the lighted candle can remove the darkness. If you don't want to do, no, again I will hold on to this, I will hold on to that, I will go down. It's up to you. I have to go and break the coconut, I have to give my hair, I have to do this, only then God will be happy. No, you carry the Lord with you.
Amen.
That's why the Bible says, verse 15, if God puts no trust in his saints and the heavens are not pure in his sight, if you don't recognize you are the saints of God,
amen,
God has put his trust in you. If you don't do, try, if you don't accept that, if you don't believe that, it's helpless. Then he says, how much less man is abominable and filthy when you are not aware of who are you in the Lord. If God is allowing you to go through some temptation, or some people are against you, some people are blaming you, don't get upset. They need light. The world in which you are living is crying for salvation. And with your love, you have to bring light to them. Romans 12:21. Don't allow the evil to overcome you. Overcome the evil with his presence, with his goodness, with his love. Be and become the person for which God created you. The goal of your life is be and become the purpose for which he called you. The world is full of sin. The world is full of darkness. People are all covered with the darkness. Don't tell, my brother is like this, my sister is like that, he is tempting me, he is doing that, he is abusing me. The world is in darkness. People of the world is covered with darkness. But he trusts you, upon you, he sends his light and he shines with his light.
Amen.
Isaiah 61:2. Yes, this is your call.
Amen.
To this dark world. The world is dying. Who will carry Jesus? Who will carry a positive language? Who will encourage this world? Only the children of God can do.
Amen.
Don't get upset with a problem. Be obsessed with the blessing.
Amen.
Don't bother about what people hurt you. Give to the world what God has blessed you.
Praise the Lord.
Isaac goes and complains to God. Lord, you helped me in this drought. Even my father Abraham went away. And with your help I dug the well. And the king Abimelech has taken it away. The Lord says, is it a complaint, Isaac? Only children of God can bless. He may be a king, but only you who knows the living God, only you can bless him. He has the land, but he doesn't have water.
Praise the Lord.
Only you have dug the well and you got the water. Give him and let him be happy. Only the children of God can bring light to the world, courage to the families. Your husband is a drunkard. Learn from Augustine's mother Monica, loved that loveless man and led him to heaven. Are you going to see the problem and cry over problem and speak of your problem and die in your problem? Or are you amidst the problem, speak up God, God's goodness, God's empowerment, God's life, God's love. He has to come to the world and you are the one he has. You are the one he has chosen.
Amen. Amen.
Don't disappoint him. Marriage means, family means, many things will come and go. Don't worry. We walk courageously. He is with you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
That's why 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 49 says, we are earthly imaged, should live with heavenly imaged. Though we are on this earth, in this clay pot, we carry the treasure of the Lord. 2 Corinthians 4:8. Yes. So though we are on this earth, we remember, we live as the divine representatives. Evil will come, disturbance will come, problems will come, people will abuse you, people will curse you, people will not forget your love. These are part of the world. Don't expect heaven from the world. Don't expect good from evil. Evil will be always evil only. You be good.
Amen.
Let the dark come against you. You don't bother about dark. Shine with the light.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
As soon as you get up, tell him who he is. And then, that is called praising God. As soon as you get up, second, thank God. Remember what God has done for you. The greatest thing is his salvation. Sending his only son for you. And dying for you. And from the day you are in the bond, in the womb of your mother, till today, how he has stood with you. So many people thought they will do this, they will, that will happen to you. Nothing has happened to you. He has led you till today. And he will lead you tomorrow also.
Amen.
Because he is the God of mountain. He is also God of the valley. It's not only for the people, those who are on the mountains. Wherever you are, your God will be with you.
Amen. Amen.
Don't forget that truth. Praise the Lord.
Praise.